Thank you, dearie. Well, during the first session this afternoon, at the beginning of the afternoon, I was supposed to be a well-balanced moderator. Now I can revert to my normal role of being an unbalanced farmer. And as a farmer, I want to manage as productive a farm as I can with as few constraints or regulations as possible. That's what I'd love to do, but I know it's the real world, and I can't do that nowadays. This session, clearly, as you see, it focuses on balancing agricultural productivity with environmental protection using the precautionary principle. And we've spoken a lot today about balance, and it's struck me, thinking about it, it's not so much a balance, it's a tension. It's very difficult to get a balance, but it's a tension between all the issues that we've heard about from the different different sides of the debate. And this tension between agricultural production increases from scientific innovation, which is brilliant, but at the same time, we need environmental protection. So I'm a farmer. I produce wheat, oilseed rape, potatoes, peas, but I'm aware that where that balance or where that tension ends up, and that will determine what scientific innovations, what scientific advances I can use on my farm, that I'll be allowed to use on my farm. Now, everything I do on my farm involves risk. There is no such thing as zero risk. There's no such thing as no risk. So I can't introduce scientific innovations on my farm without a risk, and hence the development of the precautionary principle. Of course, that's a given. But the precautionary principle, I think it's worth just going back to that a bit to remind ourselves a bit. It needs interpretation and it needs application. It needs correct interpretation and it needs correct application. We've heard about that today. And I would say perhaps I'll go back to my earlier role, failure to use the precautionary principle is foolish. If any of my industry, it's foolish to, and of course it may be dangerous, but also misuse of it, and you understand the difference between use and misuse. Misuse of the precautionary principle may be equally foolish and dangerous. And if scientific progress is made impossible, well, that's not very clever. Now, every day on my farm, or my farm manager has to assess hazard and risk. I mean, that's part of our legal obligation. Before we do a job, we have to. We saw the man with his chainsaw thinking about it. He was assessing risk. And I just want to take you back to that because I think it's very important. We know, we just need to remind ourselves hazard is the identification of the risk, and risk is a likelihood of it occurring. So there is that huge difference between hazard and risk. At the start of the day, Professor van der Sluis stated that risk assessment protocols were not fit for purpose. Now, that never got discussed because we're always short of time, so I can perhaps bring it in today. Formalise risk assessment. It tends to be developed into closed areas in mechanical systems, in factories, in aircraft. And of course, that's relatively straightforward. But agriculture, farming is different. It's not a closed system. And it's not so easy to assess risk on an open system like a farm. But it's got to be done. We have to do it, but it's not so easy. So I would say to make progress, and to the farmers here, to farm productively and profitably, we do need an understanding of the precautionary principle and the public perception that was mentioned today. And I bring you back with that needs a social scientist. That's perhaps the one bit of science been missing, because a social scientist would actually bring a scientific understanding of how people perceive risk. Consumers of my farm produce, dare I say it, many of them have a low understanding of risk. We all know the media inflates risk. I mean, on our English television, so often we see the news, agricultural campaigners, thank you very much. That says 5 minutes. Well, I didn't know I'd got along as 5 minutes. That seems a long time. You see these environmental campaigners in their white space suits with blankets on, knocking down, let's say, GM crops, trial crops, crops that are there to see whether there are any problems with GM, but they're knocking it down. And for the average person, seeing someone in white protective overalls, clothing, with maybe masks on, knocking down crops, no wonder they fear science. They really fear it, and they have no understanding of the risks, which, of course, leads to more pressure on our industry. Hence, my point is, for farming, risk analysis, risk assessment, and its understanding must be improved. And at the same time, customers for my farm product, they must have greater confidence in that risk assessment and risk analysis. That's, I think, a point that the farming industry, and I saw one or two representing it, maybe I think made a question. The farming industry has to take that on board. We focused on the precautionary principle today, Chairman. And of course, it's there, it's laudable, but it does bring economic costs to my farm and everybody else's farm. And there is a need, as we heard, to assess the cost-benefit balance for farm production. That is a balance, the cost-benefit balance. Can it be achieved? Well, it's got to be achieved. But it's achieved, well, I come back to my other word, it's achieved through the tension of the political process. That's what democracy is all about. So I guess my concluding message is, as ever, the farming industry is dependent on the decisions of politicians. I mean, we're a very, very politicized industry for regulation, but it comes back to the decisions of politicians, which I suppose is why this very important conference is taking place in the political center of Europe, and why you've put it on, Chairman.